Then we need to have another program again. We cannot stop doing something in the community. And so we enrolled them in Voice of Prophecy lessons. 29 lessons, they have a booklet, and they have to read and answer questions. No? And we challenge them to memorize the text. And mind you, these people start to memorize and they answer the questions. Many of them are perfect. And so we give some little gifts. And after that, we conducted a one-week reading campaign. And then out of those adults, 9 were baptized.
Amen.
We started with children. And then enrolled mothers class. And then later on introduced the gospel because they were already our friends. Even until now, we assign laymen, laywoman to make follow-up, and they have Bible studies to those relatives who are not yet adults. This coming December, we'll have again another crusade in that area. And we are expecting already another set of baptism. You see, we cannot win souls if we just stay in our office, stay in our church. We need to go to the community. That was the purpose of Jesus when he came to this world. He visited cities in Texas. So that is what we call love in action ministry to the community. So your care group should plan an activity to the community. And mind you, every Sabbath, you know, it will be time for reporting. And they are so excited to report whatever activities that they have. Okay. Love in action is the healthy and loving pursuit of the consciousness of compassion and mutual expression of love to where? Again, to the community. They will see that you are a compassionate church because you go there and serve the community. Some care group decided to have cooking ministry. So they go there and cook food. Some of the care group did a feeding ministry, feeding children. So they raise money, they ask donation from the U.S. and they feed. And you know, out of those activities, they invited parents to attend their care groups. And my parents attend their care groups. And I will maybe tell you later on that. Okay. Now, here's what 1 John 3:8 can say. Let's read this together. Let's start. Let us love, not in word or speech, but in truth and action. Many times you are just looking, saying, oh, we love you. In words, we love you, but you do nothing to them. The Bible says when we love, let us not just love in words, but we have to love in action. Go there. Touch people. That's people. And this is what this statement, by the way, here is the IEL vision. No? Maybe you can adapt this. Let's read together. Ready, start?
Every church engaged. Every believer involved.
Oh, I like that. Every church must engage into a ministry to the community and every member involved. As the church is engaged, every member will also involve. The church needs to engage with actions. Actions is important. We need to be more intentional. What's the word intentional? How do you understand the word intentional? You do it with purpose, right? You don't just wait for things to happen. You initiate something, and that is intentional. We need to be more intentional in reaching the people in that community using, again, Christ method. House to house visitation, and if there are some who are sick, be healed, and others. I like this one, I found this on the internet. Reach out and touch someone. Reach out and touch someone. Show them that you care. Let them know that they are not alone. Because when you go to the community, you will find so many problems, concerns, you know, a lot. But when they know that you care for them, in fact, in that community, when we have our graduation for the mothers, some of them cried. And when we gave them the testimony, they said, you know, among the many religious group that come to our place, because Ignatian Episcopal came there, Baptists came there and they said, "You are the only church that we feel that you really care for us. Because you stayed not only for 1 week, for 1 month, you stayed even for more than 1 year." But we can see the result, changed lives. And you know, a lot of people, they were not wedded. They live together without marriage. But we cannot baptize them without marriage. And so one day, I don't have the picture here, one day, we helped them. Okay, we didn't pay for their expenses. We solicited ourselves. And one day, we went, we even share, you know, share our dress. I have my white polo and I give it to them so that they will, all of them wear white. How many couples that were wedded? 9 couples that were meeting together. I tell you, they were so excited, they were so happy. And we had our celebration in SST, compound. And they have picture taking them in the crowd, very beautiful. They were so happy. And you know, after that, there were also other people there who did not attend our meeting. And they said, "Wow, beautiful. Can we also be your sponsor as to get married also?" You know, they are now asking because they see a great difference in their lives. Relationships that are not right must be corrected. And we need to help them because they don't know. They don't know. Be loving, be kind, be compassionate. Do unto others as you would have them do unto you. Powerful statement from the Bible. But many times we don't internalize those principles. We are, yeah, we are members of the church, but we don't care. But that is not the true Christianity. Remember the statement, the work of God in this earth can never be finished until the men and women comprising conscious membership rally to the work and unite their effort with those of the ministers and church offices. We need to rally together, pastors and members. Everybody involved, total member involvement, team I, from the general conference. But we can do it when we form care groups and everybody a part of that care group. Even us in the division, we need to have, because we said, oh, we are only good and giving lectures, but are we a part of the care group? Are we really going to the community? Then I said, you know, we cannot have the power to tell our people to create care groups if we will not do it ourselves. So we have to do it. And I can testify, it works. Because in our care group, we were able already to baptize 9 out of our activity in that community. Can you imagine a church with 100 members? If you divide it into 10 groups, how many groups? 10 groups. One church in Calbayo City in Central Philippines. The pastor was convinced that the care group ministry is really, it's really God's idea. And so he decided, okay, in my district, we will have all care groups. He gathered all his elders, convinced them, this is the ideal way of doing evangelism. And you know, they decided that Friday evening, no meeting in the church as usual. They will meet in their houses, 5 care groups, I tell you. And you know how many care groups they have in that one city church in Calbayo? 13 care groups. 13 care groups. So I heard about their activities because in the past, that districts cannot reach 100 souls, Pastor. Cannot reach. Although how much they do evangelism. But when they started forming care groups and use the brethren to go into the community, challenge them, and then invite people to join. The first year, they were able to baptize 130 plus. The following year, they were able to baptize 200 plus. And every year, not less than 100. No major crusades, only care groups ministry. Members inviting their neighbors, conducting programs in the community. I tell you, among those pastors who had always stopped evangelism, that pastor was number one, always. Why? Because he followed the idea of the care group ministry. Okay. So, let me just, it's in the material, but we have the IAL manual. Okay, it's there in the material. Then I would like to share with you how to use the IAL manual. What I am presenting to you is actually in the manual that you have. No? Okay, here's my suggestions. Study the IAL manual because you will become the resource person. All of you, pastor, all of you, elders, study. Is there in the materials? Read it. Study carefully. Understand it. Really master it as much as possible, because you will become a resource person. Okay, that's number one. Number two, share the material chapter by chapter. Because it is by chapter, so start with chapter 1, then go to chapter 2, then go to chapter 3. If you will do this, the brethren will understand slowly. So chapter 1 is about IEL, actually. The one that I'm sharing you is then chapter 1. And then chapter 2 and then chapter 3. You just follow chapter by chapter. And then make the seminar interesting and lively. This afternoon we'll have group activities. You will enjoy the activities in the care group. Make it lively, don't make it boring. Because people, you know, it is boring. I don't enjoy this activity. But when they participate, that's where the joy comes from. Apply workshop on group activities. I'm sorry, I did not have a workshop because I have so many materials to cover. Because we start late and time is very limited. Meet the care group leaders once a month. You pastors, will you already form care group? Please come in. Will you already form care groups? Meet the care group leaders at least once a month. And let them share their experience. You know, some of them will say, oh, this is what we do. And some of them say, oh, pastor, we have problems with this. Then you can share and you can help them. But continue the training. Once a month, please meet them. And use additional materials. If you find other materials that are useful, not only the wilderness materials, any readings that you have which you think is helpful, then use it. So that's maybe the simple guide that I can give you in using the manual, because we have already the item. I'm sorry I don't have a hard copy here, but again, it's in the soft copy that you have. Okay? So we want to be successful, right? You want to be successful? In this case, of industry, of course. The reason that you are here, because you want to learn and you want to initiate this and apply this so that you will be successful. Let's have a little, I like this success, how do you call this? Acronym. Number one S, see your goal. That's why I want you to understand IEL, because that's the goal. What is the goal? First, that evangelism will be integrated in the life of every member. IEL is for every member of the church to be involved. So those are goals that we want to meet. And then second, understand the obstacles. Of course, there are obstacles. Sometimes the obstacles are that negative attitude. We have the new starting, we always say, oh, it's difficult, you know, no, church is difficult. When you have the negative attitude, you are already defeated. But look at the potential of every member. Because I believe that God has given a gift to every member. You just need to look into that potential and encourage them to use that gift that they have for the Lord. So understand that there are obstacles, maybe financial. Maybe the area is so far. Some of you, according to pastor, has to come here 50 kilometers or 100 kilometers away. Because sometimes it's so far, I will not attend anymore, it's too far. Understand? Then create a positive mental picture. Because care group is God's idea. I will be going to that later on. It means that it works, it is the best. And so we have to have a positive attitude that it is the best, it will work. Put away negative thought. Then clear your mind of self-doubts. Sometimes, you know, Satan will suggest something to us so that we will be discouraged. Will doubt? No. Clear your mind. And then embrace the challenge. Wow, this is a challenge. I'll do this. I will embrace this. Because I know that if this is God's will, even if it is challenging, we can do it. Then stay on the track, continue. Maybe you have started already. Continue. Go, push. Make a push a little bit. And then show the world that you can do it. Others can do it, then I believe you too can do it. Conclusion, I like this statement. Let's read together. Ready, start?
Whenever the Lord wants you to do something, He will provide a way for you to do it.
Amen. When God calls us to do something, He will always provide the power, even the resources that we are doing. So this is the end of the first presentation. Do you have questions? If not, we will proceed to the next. Because I said a lot of materials for the